Here it is, the United States Military Academy, a beautiful spot on the Hudson River north of New York City, known around the world as West Point. The 4,000 men and 500 women studying here may someday lead Americans into combat. On this day, the Corps of Cadets is preparing for battle with a well-known enemy, Harvard, on the football field. But behind the pomp and precision, there is another West Point, grappling with new questions about how students are treated and trained, about the role of women and minorities, about whether the United States Military Academy is really in step with what America needs. Come along with us for 2 days and two nights, the 48 hours before that parade, behind the long gray line, and in the barracks, where America's future officers are learning about duty, honor, and country, and about themselves.
It's just another morning in Eisenhower Barracks at West Point. Home of Eagle Company. In a normal college, 18-year-old Scott Ryan and his two roommates would be freshmen, but at West Point, they are plebes.
Check the lint.
The what?
The lint on my shirt.
Members of the fourth class, the lowest form of student life.
Everybody sort of looks out for everybody in here. Huh?
It's sort of the whole idea of what they teach us. You're supposed to look out. You see, if he doesn't look good, I get in trouble.
Before dawn, the plebes are the busiest people at West Point. Today, Scott Ryan's first duty is to deliver papers. He and the other plebes have to know every article on the front page.
They're cutting $900 million if the Senate wins.
And the sports page.
Army will defeat
Marist
and women's tennis.
They also have to memorize the menus for breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Shaved roast beef, steak fries, German chocolate brownies.
And they have to know all sorts of other minutiae known here as daily knowledge. They'll be tested all day long.
Officer in charge is
Captain Champagne.
Captain Champagne.
What's the weather?
The Bush administration placed a lesser emphasis
High of 67.
On steak, mashed potatoes, cherry pie, and
additional
tropical punch.
You got it. 3 minutes.
Okay.
All right. Okay. Can you win here? Can you beat this system?
I don't think you're really supposed to win. I think you're just supposed to survive.
Survival at 6 a.m. means getting by the guys next door. They're sophomores.
What's the weather going to be like?
Sir, today the New York Times reported that the weather will be 67 degrees.
Both of them play for the Phillies.
You know, about a month ago.
Sir, for breakfast we are having hotcakes, ham slices, assorted cereals, and orange juice.
What's about face?
Right now you need to button your bottom button.
Right above your belt here.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
It's like the fifth time I told you this week about that. All right, well, you guys go ahead and get on ready to go down the formation.
Yes, sir.
Where goes there, sir?
Where goes there, sir?
Yes, sir. Where goes there, sir? Sir, back pass.
Where goes there, sir?
Where goes there, sir?
Where goes there, sir?
Good morning, sir.
Do you believe it? The buttons? I told you.
What did I tell you?
Scott Ryan and the other plebes are easy to spot at West Point, hugging the walls at 120 steps per minute. No more, no less. Every turn is made at a right angle.
Squaring corners and going along the walls, sometimes that stuff bothers me.
You don't see the point in that funny way you have to walk.
No, not really. I'm sure there is one. They just don't tell us.
It may look like they're going to breakfast quickly, but that doesn't mean they'll get there any sooner.
Ready? Front.
The alma mater. Sir, the alma mater. Hail, alma mater dear, to us be ever near. Help us thy motto bear through all the years. Ere may that line of gray increase from day to day. Live, serve, and die, we pray. West Point for thee.
You're spending an enormous amount of time reading the newspaper, memorizing menus. Where's the value there? Where's the payoff?
I think it's more of learning to be part of the system.
Sir, the hot beverage for this meal is coffee or tea. Ray would carry a cup of coffee or a cup of hot water, sir.
They're trying to develop in you a sense of duty obligation.
Sir, there are 3 hotcakes remaining on the table.
It's almost learning to follow blindly.
Sir, the 4th-class cadets at this table have performed their duties and are not prepared to eat.
My friends write me. They say college is tough. They're having trouble getting used to college, being out on their own, having so much freedom. Mine's just the opposite. I'm trying to get used to not having any freedom.
What is it about West Point? I mean, why didn't you go to Cornell or to Stanford?
The tradition attracted me. The more I learned about it, the more I liked the tradition. And I like the military aspect of it. Although we don't get that much time to work, I knew that I would work hard here because I have to. In a college situation, I would probably tend to relax and not work up to my potential.
It's 7 a.m. and Scott Ryan is facing one of the biggest challenges for a plebe, cleaning his room.
Basically, we could be inspected anytime between now and 9:15.
Scott, were you this neat when you were a civilian?
Oh, you've got to be kidding me. You should see my room at home. No way. This is definitely something I had to learn how to do. Check the shoes.
How do you find time to do everything and study, too?
Huh? That's what's giving us a lot of trouble. It is very difficult to find time to study. You can't get anything done.
Can you give me one secret?
The secret is to have a good sink. The first thing they check when they come in the room...
Come here, look at this sink, both of you. See this spot right here?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
You also have dust around it, too. Okay. Dory, this is yours, right?
Yes, sir.
See the spot in the corner right there?
Yes, sir.
Ryan, yours is even worse.
Yes, sir.
What is the importance of this?
Well, this inspection, sir?
Yeah.
Everything in the Army has a little special importance to it. For example, this would have something to do with attention to detail. In the future, if these guys are officers and they mess up one little digit or they mess up one little coordinate, they're going to blow away their whole platoon, or they're going to blow away a group of men.
We're talking about drinking glasses.
Yeah, but if they start with something this simple, when they get into the Army in the future, and they start looking at maps, and they're talking about one little number, it has the same significance as a drinking glass.
You believe that?
I believe that, and I want to see improvement.
Yes, sir. The hardest thing for me was learning the discipline. I find a lot of things funny around here, and it was really hard for me to develop the discipline.
Can you tell me what you found funny?
Well, you don't find a lot of things we do funny.
It's 8 a.m., finally, time for class.
You like boxing?
No. I'm physically tired because we don't get enough sleep. And this just pummels you. I'll be tired for the rest of the day now.
About 15% of every plebe class gets so tired of this place, they drop out.
It is hell, and there are many days where I sit at my desk and I hate it, and I want to go home, and I don't want to be here anymore, and I want to go to a regular college and be with my friends, but in the long run, it'll pay off.
Let's see some combinations now. You're jabbing.
Next week's when the bloody noses start and the broken noses, the broken jaws. Can't hardly wait.
That's it.
Let's take stock for a minute. So far this morning, you memorized the newspaper, all the menus, all the people in charge. Eaten breakfast quickly and now been beaten up.
Yeah, basically.
And your day's not even one-third over.
Now we're allowed to start being college students. Most people are just waking up. That's what we're doing. Get ready to wake up and go to class.
But before Scott Ryan gets to class, West Point has a lot more in store for him.
Hopeful and 6-time Honda Civic owner. Some people have all the fun.
You don't have to be crazy about home projects to buy a Black & Decker cordless screwdriver or cordless screwdriver plus. You just have to have a screw loose.
Next time you get heartburn, consider yourself lucky. Because Rolaids comes in assorted fruit flavors. And because it's Rolaids, you know it's effective. Calcium-rich, sodium-free, assorted flavor Rolaids. Relief never tasted so good.
You know, I've been in, been around campuses. I don't think I've ever been in a department head's office that looked quite like that. This place is different.
Well, it's different because since you can't be in the field all the time, what I try to do anyway is to bring a little of the field in my office.
Colonel Tex Turner, the director of military instruction at West Point, a warrior between wars. He suffers peacetime by trying to teach schoolboys about battle.
So the idea then is to make this office where you have to do paperwork and administrative things and planning operations look as much like a field environment as you can.
But it's make-believe.
No, it's not. It's really real.
These aren't even filled with sand.
Well, I don't know that. And if you're thinking that, it's a wrong attitude, because to be a good warrior, soldiers have to have the spirit built into them. And you do that with things like this, with flags, with symbols, with emblems of courage. It's kind of like, why do you say hooah before you attack the enemy? Well, what it does is it gives you confidence. It gives you the ability to stare the enemy right in the eyeballs and stick him with a bayonet.
Don't wait for the big one. Don't square your eyes.
What we're doing is using boxing as a means to another end. We're trying to get the cadets to deal with their fears.
The plebe boxing class is as close as many of these cadets have ever come to combat. Colonel Jim Anderson is in charge of athletic instruction.
Most of these young men that we have here in this boxing class come from our middle classes here in this country. We know, for instance, that if we should ask any of them, when was the last time you were involved in a fist fight? Over 90% of them will say, I've never been involved in a fist fight. I've often wondered, what happens if you put them out in a combat situation, and what they're doing now is facing somebody with an AK-47. It won't take too many more years where we won't have any Vietnam veterans left. We may in fact have an army that has nobody in it that has ever been in combat.
All right, good job. However, the second round, you guys are predictable. Well, vary your attack. Double jab, straight right, left hook, get at it. Or single jab, get at it. Ready?
Have fun.
So where are your warriors going to come from?
I think we've got to learn to develop training techniques that is going to give us some sort of assurance that the people that we train are in fact going to be warriors.
Most of a cadet's military training takes place during the summer. During the school year, instruction in military science is squeezed into a two-week period between semesters.
You do a SEALs, you stop, listen, look, and smell. All right, you get accustomed to the sounds of the battlefield, the smell of the battlefield. We're going to clear this by force.
If a cadet wants more military training during the school year, he has to find it in after-class activities like the tactics or mountaineering clubs.
I'm one of the people they call pretty,
It's okay.
Hardcore. I like to haze bleeds. I like to do all types of physical stuff.
Upperclassman Rick Prinz doesn't think it's enough.
It sounds kind of gung-ho and with a kid like me saying this, but I think all types of leaders, or at here, we should be learning how to be a leader during wartime. It scares me to see that maybe my fellow platoon leader or my fellow company commander, he's a leader from peacetime. His leadership style is a peacetime leadership style. And that scared him, because that's going to cost me, it's going to cost my men, that's going to cost the United States.
There, heel.
Cadets don't pay tuition, but get paid $6,300 a year to come here. All told, it costs the taxpayer about $200,000 to turn each of these cadets into officers. In return, they owe the Army 5 years active duty.
Section, attention.
West Point's mission says nothing about warriors. It calls for building leaders. In peacetime, that means managers.
Okay, thank you. Take a seat, please.
Good morning. Does it bother you that you're turning out managers these days? You say you're turning out warriors, but you and I know what goes on in the Pentagon.
Well, yeah, that's part of the... That's always part of a peacetime army, and we have to accept that. There are a lot of things I don't like about the army. Let's look at it that way. A lot of things I don't like, but I love it. I'm ready. Are you ready? Well, let's go out and lead some soldiers. Hoorah! 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 You know, as I told you before, what I got in my hand only weighs about seven and a half pounds with a fixed bayonet. It is a killer on the battlefield. Because that little bayonet right there will kill you very, very quickly. And I know that each and every one of you knows how to use it. There's no doubt in my military mind that when the time comes for you to stick this thing in somebody's gizzard, that you're going to do it. And you're going to do it just like this.
Homes in America, people rely on Kenmore appliances. No other brand can outsparkle, outfluff, or outsatisfy a Kenmore. So you don't have to go far to find the best. Come over to our house. Great low prices every day. Kenmore quality. That's your money's worth and a whole lot more.
There are rent-a-car companies better known than Enterprise, but none that know their customers better.
For the windshield wipers.
Call us. We'll come pick you up.
All right, we'll be there in 15 minutes.
Drop the car off, we'll drop you home. Because at Enterprise, we don't just care about the distance our cars go.
May I help you? Thank you.
But the distance our people go. Enterprise Rent-A-Car. We go the extra distance.
Grandpa, this is a fantastic party.
All our friends are here.
My last conscious thought will be of the core and the core and the core.
General Douglas MacArthur's last words to the all-male West Point of 1962. Today, the picture looks pretty much the same. Strong boys practicing the manly arts.
Nice. You guys start functioning at this table! I'm looking at our house! The game's up!
But not so quietly, the picture is changing.
You know the program, House! How long have you been here? How many weeks?
No word.
Hurts.
And a new voice is being heard on the plane.
Bring your units to honor our...
For the first time, a woman is captain of cadets, the leader of the Corps.
People have preconceived notions about what a woman should do and what they shouldn't do. We don't picture women in leadership roles. And I could foresee a woman platoon leader, let's say, having a lot of problems gaining the respect of troops of infantry.
Kristen Baker, the head cadet.
I hear the argument, you must have heard it, how many thousands of times. Listen, it's great to talk about women in combat, but let's get down to it. They do not have the physical strength to do the same thing as men. They're just put together differently, and that's a reality. Let's talk about that.
Well, what does it take to be a good combat leader? It probably takes agility. It probably takes a good mind. It probably takes some clear, concise thinking, ability to think on your feet, and it takes some strength, some physical strength. Now, I've been through some of the training, and I don't see myself as limited in doing any of those.
Get set, go!
I don't have a problem with not being macho or whatever and being persecuted for that. Because I think, if anything, if you are macho, if you act more masculine, then you're going to get persecuted for that rather than being a feminine figure.
I think there's a way that you can be aggressive but do it in a feminine manner.
My name is Captain Mimi Finch, and I graduated from West Point in 1983.
Hey, Harold, did you go to the rally?
Now Captain Finch watches over 130 cadets.
No one asks a male cadet, what are you first, a male? Are you a man, or are you a cadet? Are you a man, or are you an officer? Are you a man, or are you a soldier? No one asks them that. But it tends to be one of those things that they ask women, well, what do you put first? Well, no, it's compatible. Being a woman is very compatible with being a soldier and being competent.
And what about the theory that when it comes right down to it, that women have more trouble pulling the trigger than men?
I would have no trouble pulling the trigger, doing what's right, pulling the trigger.
These are original cannons. These are not facsimiles, and they're captured cannons.
But Captain Finch may never pull a trigger in combat. It's against the law.
Don't want to interrupt, but I wonder if I could take just a moment of your time. Did you know that while women are given equal opportunity in the military, they're not allowed to be in frontline combat units? I wonder if you knew that. First of all, did you know that was the law?
No, I wasn't aware.
What do you think of it?
I don't think women are emotionally equipped. I just don't think they have that type of stamina, either in spite of their training.
I don't agree. A woman can survive 4 years at West Point. I'm sure she has the emotional stamina, the mental stamina, and the physical stamina to be a leader and to represent our country in every way.
Realistically, women are going to be killed. And they're going to be killed maybe not attacking or doing something aggressive in that way, but certainly defending themselves and their mission.
Women don't have any different objectives or goals than the men do. They want the same things. And it's important to realize that, and it's important to realize that they're not doing it because they want to make a statement about anything. Women are in the military because they like the military.
We all have rights here as Americans, and some of those are the responsibilities, and the ultimate responsibility is to leave what you have in your security and your freedom and go somewhere and do something that you might possibly make the ultimate sacrifice, and that is dying for a good cause.
Prepare young men and women to be leaders for the nation. Each graduating class furthers the long and distinguished tradition of West Point producing leaders for a lifetime.
West Point is in the business of leadership. That's what we're all about. The general purpose of West Point is to create leaders of character for the nation to serve in common defense, okay?
Crenshaw High School, the inner city of Los Angeles.
We go out and we seek out, you know, individuals much like yourself.
And Lieutenant Anthony Blount is looking for a few very good young men and women.
West Point is a full scholarship. You don't have to pay tuition. You don't have to pay for books and things like that. It's all taken care of by the government.
Blount is a West Point admissions officer for the Western states. His main job, find minority recruits. And it's not easy.
I don't know whether you knew it or not, but West Point, out of the first 30 astronauts, six of them were West Point graduates.
You know, I'm trying to hit the urban centers, you know, going to inner city. And for the most part, these guys don't know anything about West Point. And it's unfortunate because they're not applying.
The application process at West Point is you have to apply for a nomination. You have to be nominated from a congressman or a senator in your district.
So historically, the congressmen just haven't had candidates to nominate?
They have, you know, the high agenda, and, you know, they might have a list of 100 things they need to do in their district. And, you know, nominations to the academy might be, you know, 50 or 60, and they got drugs and crime and, you know, homeless and things like that there.
An officer's word is his honor. A cadet's word is his honor.
I did know that there were some upperclassmen, as well as officers, that did not believe that Afro-Americans should be in the Corps or officers in the Army.
Despite his own experience, or perhaps because of it, 1958 West Point graduate, the Reverend Ron Bruner, is one of the Academy's most zealous promoters.
We believe that you have that product there. You have those young people.
Each year, he meets with Los Angeles teachers as part of his personal mission to find qualified minority students for the Point.
Are there any other quick questions?
President Kennedy began that push ordering, in fact, an increase in minorities.
Today, minority students make up 8% of the West Point population.
And we're trying to produce leaders. So we're not going to bring anybody in simply to fill that number. They have to have some leadership potential there.
Let's go, baby, let's go. Pump it up, pump it up.
We're looking at someone who is a good scholar, someone who's a good athlete, and someone who's a good leader.
Let's go, Derek. Derek.
West Point wants students like number 11, Derek Williams. At 16 years old, he's captain of the Crenshaw High football team.
High left, 36 option, no one. Got it, go, baby.
It's quarterback. And its leader.
Yeah, Derek, come on, get a pick, baby, let's go!
All the kids look up to him and respect him in a positive fashion.
Dream, yeah!
He leads by example. He doesn't talk too much.
Yeah, baby, yeah!
But his actions speaks louder than his words could ever speak.
Fire, a characteristic of a substance which can be measured without changing its chemical composition, is a physical property.
He's also top student in his class, number one out of 450 students. And he's interested in West Point, but also interested in him are Air Force, Oregon, Washington, San Diego State, UCLA, Stanford.
And then you've got some smaller schools as well?
Yeah, smaller schools. Just schools that I've never even heard of.
Win, baby.
On this Friday night, Derek Williams, the quarterback, led his team against Kennedy High.
Look, don't worry about it. As soon as you see that option, go up and hit the tailback, ball or no ball.
The game came down to the final play.
This is it, this is it, this is it.
Score tied. And lost.
Let's go. You have nothing to be ashamed of. Let's go, William. Let's go, William. You're supposed to be a leader, William.
West Point will be best for him. It'll help him grow quicker, see what Derek Williams is really all about.
You're champions.
All right. Rack like it.
Let's go.
Get
up, baby. Get your head up. No crying.
Get up, baby. Derek Williams has a lot of ability that he has not just let out, that he hasn't found out about himself.
My sinuses.
When sinus trouble strikes, reach for Nasatine. Watch as
still going. Nothing outlasts the Energizer. They keep going and going.
A new Lincoln Town Car for the 1990s has arrived. Dramatically different. A powerful V8 and more room than any other luxury car.
Your Lincoln Town Car, sir.
Lincoln, now more than ever, what a luxury car should be.
I love the sound of the rain.
And I love the taste of your fresh fruit coffee.
Thanks, but it's not fresh fruit. It's new Traeger.
Still going. Nothing outlasts the Energizer. They keep going and going and going.
48 hours will continue.
One of them did a deed. So to hide a crime of greed, none of it made any sense.
So I stuck in my 2 cents.
With Emmy winner Michael Learned, Murder, She Wrote. Then, Kevin Dobson is a hard-edged reporter.
I'm tired of religion being for sale.
In a world of false prophets, a network premiere. Money, Power, and Murder, Sunday.
I'm Harry Smith.
And I'm Kathleen Sullivan. Tomorrow, Peter, Paul, and Mary join us. Also, Martha Stewart will have holiday decorating tips.
Plus, we'll be at home with Betty Ford on CBS This Morning.
This is CBS.
My baby don't care for shows. My baby don't care for clothes. My baby just cares for me. My baby don't care for cars and races. My baby don't
share
care
the fantasy. Chanel number 5.
At Foley's.
Introducing the counter-rotating bristle action of PlaqueTrack, the home plaque removal system by Windmere. Your toothpaste works with PlaqueTrack, cleaning tooth surfaces, brushing between teeth, and under the gum line. PlaqueTrack features cordless convenience and a recharger storage base. Two easily attached brush heads are also included. Use PlaqueTrack with a program of good dental hygiene and regular professional care. Available at Kroger.
Drug trouble for two Houston cops tonight.
Enter.
If there is one thing that sets West Point apart from other academic institutions, it is discipline.
Sir, Cadet Ryan reports to the president of the board as ordered.
Ryan, before you enter and report, try it again and do it correctly. Do you know what you did wrong?
No, sir.
Order arms when you're speaking to me. About face. Does it give you a clue? About face.
No, sir.
Close the door when you enter.
Yes, sir.
Then you take steps where you reach three steps in front of the table and report to me.
Yes, sir.
Do it again.
Yes, sir.
Scott Ryan is appearing before the Eagle Company Disciplinary Board. He didn't deliver the mail on time.
Didn't you know?
In most places, that would be a mistake.
Enter!
At West Point, it is dereliction of duty.
Ryan, do you understand the importance of your job?
Yes, sir.
As a mail carrier, explain it to me.
Sir, it is my duty to ensure that all of the...
Scott Ryan is not alone.
Enter!
Sir, can I have the report to the President of Board's order?
What are we getting at here, Cooper?
Sir, we are getting at seeking responsibility and taking responsibility for my actions.
At West Point, everything counts. Everything's important.
Our cans and papers didn't get taken up Wednesday. You're dismissed. Okay. What are the matches? 4 hours. You want to give them four?
Yeah. It's just 4 hours. It's so clear cut, there's really no question about it.
Okay. All right, 4 hours.
4 hours of disciplinary marching in full dress. It's something almost every cadet does sooner or later.
Even I've walked 4 hours for security violation. I had my bayonet unlocked. Other people have a lot more walking experience. That's had quite a few.
How much walking experience do you have, Mr. Quinn?
73 hours of walking experience.
And what did you do to deserve those 73 hours?
Well, cadets may laugh about their minor infractions, but the honor code is different. It is feared and revered. The honor code is unique to West Point. It is as strict as it is simple, and every cadet knows it by heart.
A cadet will not lie, cheat, or steal, or tolerate those who do.
So you lied and violated it?
Yes.
Rod Thrower and three other cadets left campus without permission. Thrower lied about where they were to protect one of the cadets who was already in trouble. Because he had only been a cadet for a year and a half and he admitted lying, Thrower was allowed to remain at West Point. He was lucky. Most cadets who violate the honor code are expelled.
Does West Point need an honor code in the first place?
Yes. Yes.
Absolutely. You're sure?
Yes. Yes. I think all the service academies do. They have to conform to higher standards. I believe that strongly.
But perhaps the most difficult part of the honor code is that it not only holds cadets to a higher standard, it holds them accountable for other cadets as well.
If I perceive somebody committing an honor violation and I don't do anything about it, I am subject to being held accountable for my actions.
You've committed an honor violation.
Exactly, exactly.
Even if he's your best friend.
Yes.
Known him for life. Grew up next door, went through school together.
Yes.
Still have to turn him in.
Yes, that's a...
That's a pretty tough standard.
It's basically, that's the toughest thing I've found in my first year here. I had problems with dealing with. I said, you know, how can I all of a sudden just walk through this door and say, no longer, you know, I believed all my life that you're going to stick up for a buddy no matter what. And now I've got to turn a buddy in, you know, and basically risk his, you know...
Future.
His future. And I think a lot of cadets still have a problem with that.
Present, arm, and
I came here and I committed myself to 4 years here and 5 years in the military. And I risked it all on one little mistake. But I've just learned to you value things so much more. You take responsibility for what you do. That's one of the most important things I've learned. I'm held accountable for every action I do. And I know that.
The army descends on the battlefield.
We gotta contain them, and we gotta be aggressive and attack.
Only this time, the enemy is Harvard.
Go, Harvard!
Army is heavily favored.
Pressure! Pressure!
But Harvard scores first.
Come here. Come here, offense.
Coach Young tries to rally his troops.
They're coming fast. We're going to have to throw. We're going to have to run inside. Be ready to go inside. Let's go.
Do you see what happens on this field is in any way a metaphor for war?
Yes, I do. A lot of the things that we do are similar to what you do in a platoon.
We've got the blocking set up. Let's see if they get by the end. What a touchdown for Harvard.
This battle is not going well.
Clear your mind of all thoughts as you take in a deep breath.
But relax.
And then exhale slowly.
Army has a secret weapon.
Focus only on your breathing as you passively listen to my voice.
It's called performance enhancement. Head games.
Calm and relax.
Colonel Lewis Choka teaches cadets to relieve stress.
The laughter is ultimately is to be able to visualize successful performance. Number 4 inside offensive tackle with number 3 loose on offensive tackle. In other words, create very vivid mental pictures of actually successfully performing whatever it is they do. In this case, Brian is the quarterback. 67 jam, Fred.
Starting quarterback Brian McWilliams is Choka's star pupil.
Calm and relax. Brian is really more advanced in this than many of the other players, and he's very, very good at that. He's able to really picture a whole series of plays. See himself doing it successfully for the next upcoming game. Number 3 loose with tight 40 linebacker.
Slow, deep breathing.
It helped me in the area of not letting the nerves get to you too much in critical situations. I do it before the game, my nerves don't get to me. And during the game, it pretty much, you know, inside my head, you know, I'm trying to relax and then I just go out and play.
Room 42! Room 42!
Come on, home!
Raise the day all the way!
We want to be able to eventually provide this kind of training for all our cadets so that it's a part of their leadership development.
Army back out.
Because this is no different, really, than the ability of a leader to think.
All right, Ram 079.
Problem solved.
End tackle covered and two outside. Right?
React. Eliminate distractions in combat.
Let's go, play intensity.
You know, in the battlefield, tremendous chaos. And the ability to maintain focus, to maintain a calm state, and then to make critical decisions is paramount to our profession.
Okay, good job, Brian.
Sir, for this meal is German chocolate brownie. Would anyone not care for German chocolate brownie, sir?
You got a minute and a half to cut that.
Yes, sir.
The purpose of this place, in West Point's own words, is to provide the nation with leaders of character who serve the common defense.
Well, sir, so is your glass.
Diamond, that is a travesty.
Brian, watch out. Brian! Hey, I don't want to start seeing you spill that stuff all over down there. You understand me?
Yes, sir.
Don't spaz.
Even lunch is supposed to build character.
30 seconds.
Time to go, Diamond. Let's go.
The theory is, amidst this bedlam, some people are learning to lead.
Diamond, you got to get a lot quicker at this.
And other people are learning to be led.
The dessert has been cut. The dessert to Cadet Filer for inspection, please, sir.
We are not going to eat at all.
Oh, my God. You missed the center.
At Eagle Company's table, fourth classman Scott Ryan is doing his duty. Dispensing beverages.
Sir, this is your glass. Your purpose here in the fourth class system as a plebe is to decide which people you think are good leaders and which people are bad leaders and why, and evaluate that, and that's supposed to make you a better leader.
I've been here for like 3 minutes. You passed out 3 drinks. You suck. You'd starve as a bartender. Hurry up.
I'm learning a lot about leadership just by seeing the way that I'm treated by the upperclassmen.
Trivia. Eat.
Sir. Who appeared on the first cover of Playboy magazine?
Marilyn Monroe.
After lunchtime leadership, there's laundry leadership.
The laundry will come in bundles, and we have to get it out to the upperclassmen.
Who's there, sir? I need socks. I want my laundry.
And you have to arrange it to the correct room.
Fourth class.
And then you carry it through the hall.
Michael's there, sir. Oh,
my God. And knock on the door. And go in and place it on the proper desk. It doesn't sound that difficult, but...
All right, damn it. All my classmates are getting their laundry. I want mine, too.
Yes, sir.
Come on, damn it.
There are questions about the value of the fourth class system, but they are not coming from the cadets.
I'm in my junior year now, and if I had to redo the whole thing, I'd do it without a doubt.
Why?
Just a lot of it's prestige. But just the experience that I'm getting, I know is going to help me be the best leader that I can when it comes time for me to go out in the Army.
Bear with me. I'm not trying to be facetious, but how does delivering laundry this way build...
Well, it teaches you about duty motivation, that no matter what your duty is, I mean, you have to treat it as if it's the most important thing around.
Yep, go Eagles, Ryan.
Because they're put in this position...
Ken Fu is a senior and commander of Eagle Company.
Well, what's the point? I mean, if you're making these guys, I mean, here comes a guy now who's a fourth classman. Watch the way he has to walk. I mean, that's not efficient.
All that fourth class system is just a framework for you to practice your leadership on. This is just a big leadership lab we have at West Point.
But West Point is taking a hard look at how it trains leaders. Colonel Larry Donathorne is in charge of planning for West Point's future. He thinks there are problems with the fourth class system.
Those upperclassmen, as they deliver this harassment to the plebes, are not engaged in the kind of behavior that you would expect of a good leader.
There are many men here that I would follow into combat blindly and do whatever they told me to do. And then there are others that, given a combat situation, I'd be surprised if they weren't shot by their own men.
West Point is considering changes in the fourth class system to turn out officers who can win tomorrow's battles.
Often a junior officer, when he is faced with a situation and realizes he probably ought to do something, he'll freeze rather than take the action, because generally he operates in an environment where he waits for orders. And in fact, it's safer to wait and do what you're told rather than risk doing something on your own initiative and finding that it was mistaken.
The system rewards sort of safe action as opposed to creative action.
Yes, that's exactly right. And so as we expect junior officers in the future to exercise a greater degree of autonomy and initiative, we've really got to change the whole system.
If they decide to change the system, I mean, they're discussing that, as you know.
Yes.
Good idea?
No. No, I wouldn't want to stay here if they did away with the fourth class system.
But Scott, you're the victim of the fourth class system.
Yes, but next year I'll be a leader.
And for that, that's worth going through a year of what looks to an outsider, I gotta tell you, to be real hell.
Well, I think so. It is hell. You come up to a plebe today in my calculus class and you say, how do you like it here? And they'll tell you they hate it. They're not gonna lie to you, because everyone hates it here. You're not supposed to like it. You're just supposed to put up with it.
If he puts up with it for 3.5 more years, Scott Ryan will be a second lieutenant in the United States Army.
Taco chips, oatmeal raisin cookies.
For the next 6 months, he'll have to put up with being a plebe, and that's a lot of menus to memorize.
Supposed to be pizza, and it won't be apple cream pie. It'll be tortilla. Is it taco chips or tortilla chips?
Now you can lease the Cadillac DeVille for as little as $389 a month. Cadillac DeVille, named by Motor Trend magazine as the best luxury sedan buy offered by American car makers. Special smart lease terms are also available on other luxurious Cadillacs to let you travel in the passing lane without leaving your comfort zone. Cadillac, Cadillac, Cadillac
style. Kmart celebrates Christmas in America with a great selection of beautifully detailed ladies' sweaters for the holidays. On sale for $21 at Kmart. The quality you need, the price you want. Kmart celebrates Christmas in America with a huge selection of men's leather trim and other holiday sweaters. On sale for $21 at Kmart. The quality you need, the price you want.
Even after sleeping 4 long years, the Duracell batteries you know and love still give you the life you need. There's a date that proves it. Duracell, with 4 years storage.
Get the new Olympus Infinity Zoom 200. The zoom camera that significantly reduces red eye.
If you thought you had to give up comfort to get a close shave, Norelco says, think again. Their revolutionary shaving system shaves skin close in a way that's incredibly comfortable. As the hair enters the chamber, the patented lift and cut system lifts each hair and holds it a split second before a blade cuts it, so it's possible to shave skin close without the blades even touching the skin. The lift and cut shaving system from Norelco. We made close comfortable.
It's an exclusive club that cannot take any more members.
Hey, good to see you, Rusty.
We have our fair share of generals, our fair share of lieutenant colonels.
He looks good.
Our fair share of pilots.
Slim and trim.
West Point's class of 1944.
Our fair share of guys that didn't do well and guys that did well.
The free world at one time depended on this crew. And if that doesn't send cold shivers down you... What say you, Paul?
Ray Gordon has been back to West Point since graduation, but this 45th class reunion is his first.
We had a yearbook, and I was leaping through there, and I saw all of these names, and there were faces of men maybe 21 years old.
It's been a long time.
I didn't recognize them. I just wondered where they went and what they did. And which branch did you go in, Robert? I still think of myself as a kid. He was with me on the boat coming back from Germany. All these old people around me. Do you remember that? Where did they come from? They couldn't be classmates.
Now that we've retired, we want to come back and lie to one another about what happened. That's what reunions are all about, lying about whatever went on.
I remember I was a company runner on those maneuvers. I spent the entire maneuvers chasing a unit that had already moved.
Alan Weston and Spike Geltz met as plebes in 1941.
He was my roommate for 3 years. We would stay together for 3 years because nobody else would have him and nobody else would have me.
Nobody could be more underrated than you were, Geltz.
When you go through 3 years of the experiences we went through, you just never forget them.
Oh, brave old army. Come on, sing.
This reunion has special meaning for Geltz and Weston. West Point's basketball arena is being named in honor of their teammate, Ed Crystal. He died in combat just before the end of World War II.
Ladies and gentlemen, taking their place on the reviewing line are members of the United States Military Academy class of 1944.
Saturday morning. A West Point cadet review in honor of the class of 1944.
You know, I often think of what we looked like 40 years ago on this same piece of grass.
474 young men were graduated from West Point on D-Day, June 6, 1944. Since then, 123 have died. Some fought in World War II, Korea, and Vietnam.
You know, that's really something, honest to God.
It really is. I'm frankly impressed.
A lot of the cadets marching here today are hoping the West Point experience will do something for the rest of their lives. What has the West Point experience done for you?
A dedication to our country. A lifetime service to this country.
And a lifetime of friendships.
Best friend I ever had.
Same way with me.
Hold it!
Well, it's my second family.
Eyes here again! Hold it!
And I think you'll find that if you talk to any one of these old FUDs.
For more than 180 years, West Point graduates have fought and died on battlefields all over the world. On both sides in the Civil War, two World Wars, Korea, Vietnam. Today, in peacetime, a new generation trains to fight again, to carry the stars and stripes into battle, if all else fails. I'm Dan Rather. Until next week, that's 48 hours. Here's a look ahead to next week. A journey to a forgotten country.
Son, I somehow get the feeling that your mind is not on this championship match. Still thinking about North Dakota, huh? That cemetery where Kirby found out about her mother.
Actually, I was thinking about my own mother. How unnecessary, how cruel it was of her to throw the truth at Kirby the way she did.
Cruel? Well, your mother can win prizes at that sort of thing if she sets her mind to it. But in this case,
don't say she hadn't been useful.
She did. You